Hello students, today we will be discussing about radial and transverse velocity and acceleration. Firstly, we will discuss about the definition of both, and then we will find the expression in polar coordinates and vector coordinates. So what is radial velocities? Consider the curve r is equals to f of theta. So at point B, at time t, the position of the particle is at point P, and at time t plus delta t, the position of the particle is at point Q. Now r vector is the position vector when the particle is at point P, and r vector plus del r vector be the position vector when the particle is at point Q. So V is the velocity at point P. Now resolving the components of V at point P along the radius vector and perpendicular to the radius vector. The component which is along the radius vector is the radial velocity. That is the resolved part of the velocity of P along the radius vector in the sense of r increasing is the radial velocity. Right? Which is V cos theta. Similarly, the resolved part of the velocity at P along a line through P but perpendicular to the radius vector OP vector, that is V sin alpha, is our transverse velocity. Similarly, we have the definition of radial and transverse acceleration. That is the resolved part of the acceleration at P along the radius vector in the sense of r increasing is our radial acceleration, and the resolved part of the acceleration at P along a line through P but at right angle to the radius vector OP vector and in the sense of theta increasing is our transverse acceleration. Now we will find out the expressions for radial and transverse velocity in polar coordinates. Suppose we have given a curve r is equals to f of theta, and the position of coordinates of point P at time t is r theta, and coordinates of Q at time t plus delta t is r plus delta r comma theta plus delta theta. Now firstly we have to find the radial and transverse velocity at point P. So we have to draw a perpendicular on OP produced through point Q, that is QM is that perpendicular. So with the help of Pythagoras theorem and trigonometric identities, we have QM is equals to r plus delta r sine delta theta, and OM is equals to r plus delta r cos delta theta. So radial velocity at P along OP is displacement along OP in time delta t, which is PM. So PM is given by OM minus OP. PM is given by OM minus OP. So OM is our r plus delta r cos delta theta, and OP is r vector. So now here opening the expression for cos delta theta, which is 1 minus delta theta square 2 factorial up to so on. Now delta theta is very small quantity, so neglecting the square and higher terms of delta theta, we will get limit delta t tends to 0 r plus delta r minus r upon delta t. So cancelling r with minus r, we get limit delta t tends to 0 del r by del t. So applying the limit delta t tends to 0, we will get the radial velocity at point P, that is dr by dt. Now this velocity can be written as r dot, where dot depicts the first order derivative of r with respect to time t, and this radial velocity is positive towards r increasing. Similarly, we have to find the transverse velocity at P. Transverse velocity is along perpendicular to OP, which is Q1. So transverse displacement along QM is MQ, which is limit delta t tends to 0 r plus delta r sine delta theta. Here what we have to do, either we have to open the expression of sine delta theta, which is delta theta minus delta theta cube upon 3 factorial. This is the expression of sine delta theta, right? Either we have to open this expression over here, or we have to done with the using this formula, limit x tends to 0 sine x by x is equals to 1. This is your choice, what you want to do over here. Similarly, we will get limit delta t tends to 0 r plus delta r, multiplying and divide by angle of sine, that is delta theta. Now sine delta theta upon delta theta and limit tends to 0 is our 1. So this expressions become 1. Delta r is very small quantity that can be neglected. So we here left with r delta theta upon delta t. Applying limit delta t tends to 0, we will get transverse velocity at P as r d theta by dt, which is positive towards theta increasing. Next is our resultant velocity. Resultant velocity is square root of radial velocity plus square of transverse velocity. Now, on similar steps, we will derive expression for radial and transverse acceleration. Firstly, we will resolve the velocity at point P. Velocity at point P along OP is u vector. U vector is dr by dt, and velocity perpendicular to OP is v vector. V vector is r d theta by dt. Now, acceleration at P along OP is change in velocity along OP in delta t, which is given by this expression u plus delta u cos delta theta plus v plus delta v cos 90 plus delta theta minus u. So cos of 90 plus theta is minus sine theta. This now opening expression for both cos delta theta and sine delta theta, we will get this expression. Now here delta theta is very small quantity, neglecting square and higher powers of delta theta, we will get this expression u plus delta u into 1 minus v plus delta v into delta theta minus delta u over delta t, and limit delta t tends to 0. Now cancelling u with minus u, we will left with only delta u by delta t minus v delta theta by delta t minus delta v by delta t into delta theta. Here delta v is also very small quantity, so this quantity can be neglected. So we neglect delta v, we will left only with these two quantities, and apply delta t tends to 0, partial derivative changes into total derivative. So we will get du by dt minus v d theta by dt, equating the expressions for u and v, which is given in equation number 1. We will get radial acceleration at P as d2r by dt square minus r d theta by dt ka whole square, which is positive as in the sense of r increasing. Now transverse acceleration at P is acceleration at P perpendicular to OP, which is given by limit delta t tends to 0 u plus delta u sine delta theta plus v plus delta v sine 90 plus delta theta minus v. Sine 90 plus theta is our cos theta. Opening expressions for both sine delta theta and cos delta theta, and neglecting square and higher powers of delta theta, we will get limit delta t tends to 0 u plus delta u into delta theta plus v plus delta v into 1 minus v over delta theta. So now plus v is cancelled out with minus v, and delta u is very small quantity, so this can be neglected. Okay. And applying the limit delta t tends to 0, we get u d theta by dt plus dv by dt. Equating expressions for u and v, we get this term. Now, derivate second expression, second term from here, we will get this expression. Now, take 1 by r as common and summarize this as derivative of r square by d theta by dt. This is our transverse acceleration at P and positive in the direction of theta increasing. Now next is vector method to find the radial and transverse velocity. First we have to consider the curve r is equals to f of theta, and P be the position of the curve at time t, and r vector be the position vector. O is origin and OX is our fixed line. Now OP vector makes angle theta with O, fixed line OX. Now r vector it can be written as the magnitude of r vector and into my unit vector along op vector, that is r cap. Now this r cap can be written as the unit vector along x axis and y axis, that is cos theta I cap plus sin theta j cap. Take if n cap is the unit vector perpendicular to op, then n vector can be written as the cos of 90 degree plus theta I cap plus sin of 90 degree plus theta j cap. Cos 90 plus theta is minus sin theta and sin 90 plus theta is cos theta. So firstly we will differentiate r cap with respect to time t. So we will get minus sin theta d theta by dt I cap plus cos theta d theta by dt j cap. Taking d theta by dt common from both the expressions, we will get d r cap by dt is equals to n cap d theta by dt. Now differentiating this n cap with respect to time t, we will get d n cap by dt is equals to minus r cap d theta by dt. So now what is v vector? V vector is dr vector by dt. R vector is our r into my r cap. So firstly we will differentiate this expression. Then we will find expression in terms of r cap and n cap. The coefficient of r cap gives us the radial velocity at p, and the coefficient of n cap gives us the radial velocity at coefficient of n cap gives us the transverse velocity at p, component of transverse velocity at p. So radial velocity as p at p is dr by dt, and transverse component is r d theta by dt. So next is our radial and transverse acceleration. Now we know the expression of radial. So now we know the expression of velocity. V vector dr by dt into my r cap plus r d theta by dt into n cap. Firstly we will differentiate this with respect to t. So differentiating this term, treating r cap as constant, plus differentiating r cap, treating first term as constant. Similarly we will differentiate our second term. Firstly differentiate dr by dt, treating this as constant. Then we will differentiate d theta by dt, treating r and n cap as constant. Then we will differentiate d and n cap, treating r d theta by dt as constant. So what we will get? We will get d2r by dt square into r cap plus dr by dt, and substituting the value of dr cap by dt. Dr cap by dt is our n cap d theta by dt. N cap d theta by dt. This term dr by dt into d theta by dt n cap plus r d2 theta by dt square into my n cap. Plus we have to substitute the value of dn cap by dt, which is minus r cap d theta by dt. ठीक है जी. तो इसमें अब हम क्या करेंगे, अब फिर से हमें रेडियल और ट्रांसवर्स कंपोनेंट निकालना है एक्सेलरेशन का. दैट इज़ वी विल टेक आर कैप कॉमन एंड एन कैप कॉमन. द कोफिशेंट ऑफ आर कैप विल गिव द रेडियल कंपोनेंट ऑफ रेडियल एक्सेलरेशन, एंड कोफिशेंट ऑफ एन कैप विल गिव द कंपोनेंट ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स एक्सेलरेशन, विच इज़ गिवन एज now radial component of acceleration is d2r by dt square minus r d theta by dt ka whole square, and transverse acceleration component is twice of dr by dt into d theta by dt plus r d2 theta by dt square. So these are the expressions for radial and transverse acceleration in vector form. Now coming to our very first example, in this example we have given a point P moves with a constant angular velocity about O, where O is the pole of the equiangular spiral. R is equal to AEQ theta. Obtain the radial and transverse acceleration as at P. Now equation of the curve is R is equals to AE theta. Since angular velocity is constant, that is omega is constant, that is d theta by dt is constant. So here d theta by dt is constant. So we have given our curve r is equals to a e ki theta, differentiating that curve with respect to time t. Dr by dt is a e ki theta d theta by dt. D theta by dt is our omega and a e ki theta is our curve r. So we will get this expression. Now we have to find out the radial and transverse acceleration. Once again differentiating this expression, dr by dt, then we will get d2r by dt square omega dr by dt. Now dr by dt is r omega, substituting this value we get d2r by dt square is equals to omega square r. Now we have expression for radial acceleration as this and this. Substituting the value of d2r by dt square here and d theta by dt square here, we will get our radial acceleration as omega square r minus r omega square, which is 0. Similarly, we will get transverse acceleration as 2 omega square r. So this is our first example which we have discussed. Now we will discuss another example. Suppose an insect travels at a constant rate u along the spoke of a cartwheel of radius a, and cart is moving with velocity v. Find the accelerations along and perpendicular to the spoke. Suppose in this figure we have given OA be the spoke and initial the particle is at point O. After some time t, position of the particle is OB and insect reaches at point P. Means the particle is not at point P, instead the particle is at point P, which is between OP. Okay, so this angle AOB is our angle theta. OA is our initial line with constant velocity u. Constant velocity is our u. Insect travels at constant rate, that is u, along the spoke of a cart. Means u is our velocity along OA. Theek hai ji? So OP distance is ut. Radial velocity of the insect is dr by dt. Dr by dt is our u, which is along radius. So radius velocity is OA. OA is our u vector, and transverse velocity is a d theta by dt, which is v, which is given as the cart is moving with velocity v. So from here and here we will find out the expression for d theta by dt, which is v by a. Both expression number first and second are constant. Now differentiating this with respect to t and this with respect to t, we will get r dot dot is equals to 0 and theta dot dot is equals to 0. Now putting these values in expression for radial acceleration, we will get radial acceleration as minus ut into may v square upon u square, and transverse acceleration is 2 uv by a. Similarly, you can do another examples of this exercise. And you can also try your exercise questions. Now moving to our next topic, that is tangential and normal velocities, intrinsic coordinates. So what is this? In this we have to find out the expression for tangential and normal velocities in intrinsic coordinates, then we will go with vector coordinates. Suppose we have given a curve AB where A is the fixed point on the plane curve AB of the moving particle. P and Q be the position of the particle at time t and t plus delta t. Arc AP is our S and arc AQ is our S plus delta S, so RPQ is our delta S. Now angle QM is our perpendicular to vector OP produced. We joined the chord PQ. So Q tends to P when theta tends to 0. So tangential velocity at P is that is which is along the tangent at P. So tangent and P is our OP vector. Tangential velocity at P is displacement along OP, which is our PM. So PM is given by applying Pythagoras theorem and triangle trigonometric identities in triangle PQM. We will get PM is equals to PQ cod PQ into my cos theta. So limit delta t tends to 0, PM by delta t is equals to cod PQ cos theta by delta theta. Now we will multiply and divide by arc PQ. Arc PQ. When delta t tends to 0, this cod PQ and arc PQ will get to 1, and theta tends to when theta tends to 0, cos theta tends to 1 and cod PQ upon arc PQ tends to 1. So we will just left over with del s by del t. Del s is here arc PQ into my cos of theta, which is our PQ, and PQ is del s. Okay, so tangential velocity is ds by dt. Now normal velocity at P, which is perpendicular to tangent, is our QM, which QM is equals to cod PQ into my sine of theta. Multiply and divide by del s. When theta tends to 0, this cod PQ and del s tends to 1, but sine theta tends to 0, so this whole expression will go to 0, so normal velocity is 0. Now coming to normal and tangential acceleration. Similarly, we will consider the same curve, and tangential velocity at P is, tangential velocity is at P is del s by del t. We have derived this earlier. Tangential acceleration at P is change in velocity along the tangent at P in time delta t. This change is given by V plus delta V cos of delta phi minus V over delta t. Opening the expression of cos delta phi, neglecting the square and higher terms of delta phi, we will get V plus delta V into 1 minus V. V will cancel out with minus V, so we will left over with delta V by delta t. Applying limit delta t tends to 0, we will get dv by dt. Now put it back and put the value of V over here, that is ds by dt. So we will get d2s by dt square. So finally tangential acceleration is dv by dt, which is d2s by dt square, which is also equals to V dv by ds. Right. Now coming to the normal acceleration. Since we know that the particle has no velocity along the normal at P, so change in velocity along P is just V plus delta V sine delta phi. So average rate of change of velocity along the normal at P is V plus delta V into sine phi over delta t. Applying limit delta t tends to 0 and opening the expression of delta phi, we will get V plus delta V into delta psi by delta t time. Delta phi by delta t. Now delta V is also very very small quantity that can be neglected. V delta phi by delta t. Apply limit delta t tends to 0. We will get V t phi by dt. Now multiply and divide by ds. Ds by dt is our V and d phi by dt is our rho, which is radius of curvature. So normal acceleration is V square by rho. Now this is the expression for normal and tangential acceleration in intrinsic coordinates. Next we will find out the expressions for tangential and normal for both velocities and acceleration in vector method, by vector method. So firstly consider the same curve A B with A as the fixed point, P and Q be the position of the particle at time t plus and t plus delta t. R K P is our S, R A Q is our S plus delta S, and R P Q is our delta S. So displacement in time t, delta t is delta r vector. Velocity of the particle at p is given by v vector is equals to limit delta t tends to 0 curl r vector by curl t. When we apply the limit, we get v vector is equals to dr vector by dt. Now here, t cap denotes the unit vector along the tangent at p in the direction of s increasing, and n cap be the unit vector normal at p in the direction of inward drawn normal. Inward drawn normal is our this, which is represented by n. Okay. So t cap is dr vector by dt upon my magnitude of the same vector. Magnitude of dr vector by dt is our ds by dt. So we will get t cap is equals to dr vector over ds. Dr vector is our ds is denotes the unit tangent vector in the direction of s increasing. So firstly, v vector is given by dr vector by dt, multiply and divide by ds. Dr vector by ds is our t cap into ds by dt. So here the components of the velocities along tangential is ds by dt and normal direction is 0. Resultant velocity of a particle is always along the tangent to its path. This is the main conclusion, that you need not have to find out the normal direction ke along aapko velocity find out karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Next is our tangential and normal acceleration. So unit tangent and unit normal vector at p in terms of I cap and j cap is given by t cap is equals to cos phi I cap plus sin phi j cap. Now this n cap is our normal, so we have to add 90 degree angle to both sine and cos. We will get n cap is equals to cos 90 plus phi I cap plus sin 90 plus phi j cap. Cos 90 plus theta is our minus sin theta, and sin 90 plus theta is our cos theta, right? Firstly, we will differentiate t cap with respect to time t. We will get dt cap by dt is equals to n cap into my d phi by dt. Now, what if we take acceleration as the a vector at particle at point p? So, a vector is our dv vector by dt. What is v vector? V vector is just v into my t cap. Differentiating this, we have to open this v expression. Firstly, we will differentiate v with respect to t, treating t cap as constant. Then we will take v as constant and differentiate t cap with respect to t. Now we will substitute the values of dt cap over dt from this expression. That is our equation number 2, right? What we will get here is d a vector is equal to dv by dt into t cap plus v d phi by dt into n cap. Now this multiply and divide by ds, this whole term. Ds by dt is our nothing but v, and dv by ds is taken as it is. So we get at the last acceleration is dv by dt into t cap plus v square by rho into n cap. Now here rho is ds by d phi, which is the radius of curvature at p. This components of acceleration along tangential direction is dv by dt, which is positive in the sense of r increasing, and normal direction is v square by rho, which is positive in the direction of inward drawn normal. So with this article, we have completed articles of our first chapter. Now we will discuss some questions. Firstly, the particle describes the cycloid S is equal to 4a sine phi with uniform speed v, and its find its acceleration at any point. So first, we have given the tangential uniform speed v. Speed is uniform, that is V is constant, and tangential acceleration is our dv by dt, which is equals to 0. Equation is given, cycloid equation is given over here. So for what we have to done, we have to differentiate this expression with respect to phi, angle phi. We get d phi is equals to 4a cos phi, and ds phi by d phi is our rho, that is radius of curvature. So tangential acceleration is 0, so we have to find out with only normal component. Normal acceleration is given by v square by rho, so v square upon 4a cos phi. Now opening the expression of cos phi is square root of 1 minus sine square phi. Taking 4a under the square root, we get v square upon square root of 16a square minus 16a square sine square phi. Now what is s square is 16a square sine square phi, so substituting value this as s square, so this is our resultant acceleration. As our tangential acceleration is 0, so normal acceleration is our resultant acceleration. Next question is, a particle describes a curve for which s and phi vanish simultaneously with uniform speed v. If acceleration at any point s be this, prove that the curve is a catenary. Here this acceleration given is our resultant acceleration. So what we have given? We have given v as constant. What is ds by dt as constant? Here tangential acceleration dv by dt is also 0. So we are left over with normal acceleration. Normal acceleration is our resultant acceleration. So equating both normal and resultant acceleration, we get this expression. Cancelling out v square from both the sides, we will end substituting the value of rho as ds by dxi. We get this expression. Now integrating this expression, we get c ds s square plus c upon me s square plus c square equal to d phi. So after integration, we get tangent inverse s by c is equals to phi plus a. S and phi vanish simultaneously. जब s 0 होगा तो phi 0 होगा, तो यहाँ से a की वैल्यू आ गई कि a 0 होगा. ये हमारी एक्सप्रेशन आ गई जब हमने a को 0 को लिखा, विच इज़ द इंट्रिंसिक इक्वेशन ऑफ अ कैटेनरी. नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज, अ पार्टिकल मूव्स इन अ प्लेन सो दैट इट्स टेंजेंशियल एंड नॉर्मल एक्सेलरेशन आर इक्वल एंड द टेंजेंट रोटेट्स विद कॉन्स्टेंट एंगुलर वेलोसिटी. हियर एंगुलर वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट, दैट इज ओमेगा इज कॉन्स्टेंट. शो दैट द इंट्रिंसिक इक्वेशन ऑफ द पाथ इज दिस एंड ए बी आर कॉन्स्टेंट. नॉर्मल एक्सेलरेशन इज वी स्क्वायर बाय रो. In this question, we have given tangential acceleration and normal acceleration. Both are equal. So, equating both as equal, that is d2s by dt square is equal to v square by rho. Tangents rotates with constant angular velocity, that is omega is constant, which is d psi by dt is constant. Where psi is the angle which the tangent to the curve at any time makes with x-axis. Now, equating this expression, we get v dv by ds is equals to v square by rho. Cancelling v from both the sides, we get dv by ds is equals to v by rho. Equating the value of rho as ds by dxi, we get dv by, and assembling this equation as v terms of v and derivative of v comes at left hand side, that is dv by d is equal to dxi. Now integrating, नीचे फंक्शन है ऊपर उसका डेरिवेटिव पड़ा है, तो लॉग वी इज इक्वल्स टू साई प्लस कॉन्स्टेंट लॉग वी डैश. नाउ टेकिंग लॉग वी डैश लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, वी गेट लॉग वी बाय बी डैश इज इक्वल्स टू साई. वी इज इक्वल्स टू बी डैश ई रेज टू पावर साई. टेकिंग एंटी लॉग बोथ द साइड्स, वी गेट वी बाय बी डैश इज इक्वल्स टू ई साई. सो वी इज इक्वल्स टू बी डैश ई साई. What is v? V is our ds by dt multiplying and divide by dxi. है व्हाट वी हैव डन. सो ds बाय dxi इज सॉरी dxi बाय dt इज आवर ओमेगा व्हिच इज कांस्टेंट दिस. सो टेकिंग ओनली सो एट लेफ्ट हैंड साइड वी विल लेफ्ट ओवर ओनली विद ds. ds इज इक्वल्स टू b डैश बाय ओमेगा ezi इनटू dxi. अगेन इंटीग्रेटिंग वी गेट x इज इक्वल्स टू a प्लस b e की xi where b dash by omega is our b which is the required equation of the path. So this is our last example of this chapter. I hope you understand the today's lecture. Thank you.